Hi everyone, today on Typical Books we're going to do the, do I have that book tag, Chilled Out Horror Edition. So this tag has always caught my eye, and it comes from keeping tabs. I'm sure a lot of people I know have done it, I just couldn't find any of them. I just spent the last half hour scouring all my favorite subscriptions, favorite booktubers, and even some that I thought I might have stumbled upon but didn't subscribe to. I couldn't find anyone that did this, and I swore there were a few, oh my god, people that I know had done this, and it's driving me nuts. Driving me almost as nuts as it will to find these books. So for those not familiar, there are 20 little challenges. One second. That's a good coffee. And you have about 8 minutes. The original tag creator took 8 minutes to answer these, and she didn't get them all. It's quite challenging. I'm only doing my small bookshelf, as you see behind me. I'm not gonna run up and down stairs. Maybe someday I will run upstairs and see if I can do this all in 8 minutes when I'm feeling particularly energetic. Unlike today, obviously. It's just a chill version. I'm gonna try and make 8 minutes, so we'll see how it goes, starting once I put my coffee down. Okay, a few of my little stipulations. It's of course gonna try and stick in the horror. There is some nonfiction here, and there are some books you can't see in my V.C. Andrews collection. And I'm going to try and stay away from the paperbacks, but we'll see, because that is just a mess. Okay, so my first question is, do you have a book with deckled edges? And, well, you know what? The first one that pops into my mind is Kill Creek, because a lot of people didn't like the deckled edges in Kill Creek. So that is a book with deckled edges. Oh, I can already see that I'm going to have trouble with this. I've watched quite a few versions of this, and I've seen quite a few people not struggle at all. They struggle more with getting around their giant book collection, but I think that this would be easier for YA people. Do you have a book with three or more people on the cover? Oh god. It's horror, man. There's like, if there's one person on the cover, and I don't really buy books that have, like, people on the cover. Oh my god! I'm already stuck at the second question! Oh no. Sons of Cain? Does that count? There's a whole bunch of people on the cover. Vlad the Impaler, got Myra Hindley, got all kinds of killers, little Jeffrey Dahmer. Yeah? Okay. So, this sucks. Do you have a book based on another fictional story? I do. Robert Bloch's Psycho Sanitarium by Chet Williamson. Okay, do you have a book with a title 10 letters long? It's like I'm just, is clockwork. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh no. Experience. Yeah, Society of Experience, but Matt Cahill, that has 10 letters, right? Yeah, Experience, 10 letters. Or does it have to be exactly 10 letters long? Like Despumation, I have upstairs, D-E-S-P-U-M-A-T-I-O-N, more than 10, whatever, I don't know. 10 letters exactly? Including the word the? Experimental film. Horror Store, H-O-R-R-O-R-S-T-O-R, we have a winner, Horror Store. So I'll put Matt Cahill's book back for another challenge and Horror Store. Sorry if I'm off mic entirely for this, but hey, I'm having fun. Number 5, do you have a book with a title that starts and ends with the same letter? And Kink by Kathy Koja. Just as soon as I saw it, you know what? Kill Creek does too, but Kink, that's with the K's. Is it? I know I want to watch all these videos and see how many K's end up in that question. Do you have a mass market paperback book? Do I? I mean, Mina's Child by Paul Butler is right here. Gorgeous, gorgeous book. Most of these are mass market paper books. Hello, horror. Number 7. Do you have a book written by an author using a pen name? I do. I have, oh my god, where are we here? The Deep by Nick Cutter. I also have some Jack Ketchum. That's a pen name. But we all know Nick Cutter. It's not his real name. Number 8. Do you have a book with a character's name in the title? Well, Mina's Child. I mean, but I already did that one, right? So it's like I'm just starting at the beginning of my bookshelf. I'm sort of cheating like that. Okay, I don't know. Who? Yeah, I must, right? I know I do. I do. Right? Okay. It's like I'm asking you guys. Help! What have we got here? Use me as child again? I mean, is there... I don't know. There's no rule against that, is there? Okay, well, Red by Jack Ketchum. Red is the name of a character. Do you have a book with two maps in it? Well, I'm sure I do. I know I would upstairs because I have the Tolkien companion up there, but I said I'm going to stick down here. Let me just see if Wolf's Head has maps in it. Wolf's Head has a map on the front. Let's see if Wolf's Head has maps in it. It has a map. Let's see if it has another map. There's your daily ASMR. Well, does it count if it has a map on the front that's old and a map inside that's new? I'm gonna hope that counts. Invisible landscape. It's not about landscaping, kids. It's about taking mushrooms and telling fortunes. Wow. I have a feeling Horror Store has maps. Like, Horror Store does have maps of the store. Does that count? Today's tag video is brought to you by delicious coffee I brewed upstairs. It's actually one half Lavazza Rossa and one half of Tim Hortons Hazelnut. Number 10. Do you have a book that was turned into a TV show? Well, shit. Yeah. I'm gonna have to go with... Is this cheating? If I say Shirley Jackson, we've got The Haunting of Hill House. Yeah, right? Is this a Netflix show? Is that a TV show? Like this? Yeah, it's gotta be, right? It's gotta be. Number 11. Do you have a book written by someone who is originally famous for something else? A celebrity, athlete, politician, TV personality? Oh, I like this book stack. This is comfy. I can just lean here. Oh, I don't know where it is, but I have David Cronenberg's book. He was famous for making movies, and then he wrote a book. Kate Hartfield. I don't know if this will count for everybody. Kate Hartfield, Armed in Her Fashion. Kate was famous, to me, for being the editor at Ottawa Citizen. So she is a celebrated journalist and then turned to writing fiction. Well, she wrote fiction while she was a journalist too, but she didn't become a novelist in her own right until she had been done with the newspaper business. Number 12. Do you have a book with a clock on the cover? That's tough. I mean, with horror, there should be, like, if I had Nancy Drew, I would have a book with a clock on it, like Secret in the Old Clock. I would just be lucky to guess one with a clock or clock tower on the cover. And this is another instance where I have a feeling that someone can see a book here that they know has a clock that I'm like not putting two and two together. Oh my. Well, I'm going to take a wash on that one. I mean, I don't have a book with a clock on the cover that I can think of. And I think there is one upstairs with a lock and key cover. Okay, so I'm going to have to miss number 12. Lucky 13. Do you have a poetry book? I do. Susan Musgrave's Embalmer Art. I think it might be upstairs though. I have Susan Musgrave's The Embalmer's Art upstairs, and I also have the poetry of Edgar Allan Poe upstairs as well. I suppose I have sonnets. Shakespeare sonnets. That works, right? Right. Number 14. Do you have a book with an award stamp on it? Yeah. I mean, a lot of them do. Well, I know some of them are nominated. I think I'm going to take a wash on that too. So really, number 14, 12 and 14, I couldn't do. 15, do you have a book written by an author with the same initials as you, LP? Let's see, I'll just go to the P's, L-M-N-O-P. No, I don't. Not down here anyway. Oh, you know what? probably in all my paperbacks. I would have to get back to you on that. I don't think I do. And you know what? In the amount of time that I have, I'm trying to beat 8 minutes here, which I don't think I'm gonna. I don't think I do. So, okay, that's three questions I haven't been able to do. Wow, that's bad. Number 16, do you have a book of short stories? Yes, I do. I could just probably reach up randomly and grab one. So, let's see. We have Matt Shaw Presents Masters of Horror. So there we go, a book of short stories. And there are many of them here. My gosh. Number 16, do you have a book that is between 500 and 510 pages long? That's random. Okay. Let's see. If I just guess, Dog Blood, David Moody. What have we got here? 321. So I need a big thick tome. A big, silly old thick tome. 470. No, it's 400, 500. It's hard to guess with the thickness of papers here. That's kind of a mean one, right? Because I don't want to dig out a whole bunch of stuff. I'm gonna skip this question. The law of averages says that yes, I do indeed have a book that is between 500 and 510 pages. I'm looking forward to the next iteration of this tag. Do I have that other book? Number 18. Do you have a book that was turned into a movie? Yeah, I do. Right here, actually. And it's like I keep reaching just for these. I'm Thinking of Ending Things. Here, by Ian Reid. There we go. Nicely done, Lydia. Do you have a graphic novel? Up here, no. But we know I do have graphic novels. Do I have anything with graphics in it right here? Yes, I do. I have Putrefaction, Black Bile. It is an anthology, a zine anthology by Justice Stefaniak, and I helped lay this out, so it's really cool. That's a throwback. So yeah, I do have a graphic novel down here. Lucky me. So the next question is, number 20. Do you have a book written by two or more authors? Barring things like short story collections and stuff like that, let's see. Do I have any dualies here? Yes, indeed. I'm on page 44 of Out Behind the Barn by Chad Lutsky. I was right, and John Bowden. So that is a book by two people. And I guess if you can count the Rob Zombie book, that's by two people as well. And I don't have them down here, but I do have the Dacre Stoker books, which are written by two people. So I really wish I could answer this a little better, but I do have a phone, Kindle on my phone, and I am in the middle of reading a really cool book by two people. So, wow, that took a lot to answer all of those questions. Oh my God. I am looking forward to the second one, and I hope you enjoyed this mostly horror edition of Do I Have That Book? I'm going to put my bookshelf back together and then decide if I'm going to tackle the second one. But so that is that. Wow. Coming up, I do have another tag coming up because I really like this spooky version of the Do You Have That Book tag. And I'm going to do Fall Vibes, which does center around BookTube in a big way. And I thought that what better way to pay a little bit of love forward to other BookTubers. I've been in a lot of collaboration videos lately because it is our season to shine as far as horror BookTube goes. So I'd like to use the Fall Vibes book tag to talk about some of my favorite BookTubers and maybe introduce you to a few if you had missed them. So thank you very much for watching. Do you have that book? Like, did you do this tag? Were you one of those people that I was searching for in the past half hour that I might have missed out? Let me know in the comments below. You can link straight to your video if you want. And have a nooky spooky day.